at you, officer.
Stop! Und das ist was war.
You must understand that we are going through a very important excise throughout the state, and that excise is an excise in democracy at the grassroots level. Enthusiasm of the people with which they are coming out and participating in the elections is commendable. And very elaborate security arrangements have been made along the polling routes, polling stations, and the polling places. But despite best of your arrangements that you make, you cannot put 100% curfew or civil curfew where people are not allowed to move. People have to go. It's a big exercise, as I said. Movement has to be ensured. So among a very large-scale movement of the people, you have a hidden movement of an odd anti-national element coming to city or coming to some other place. Yesterday only you have had an incident in Punch where Lashkar-e-Toba group of terrorists was sent from Pakistan, and they tried to come over to Shopian. They could not because of the heavy snowfall, and a police party along with army tracked them down after 3 days, carried out an operation wherein they were asked to surrender so that we could show to the entire world that that is how Pakistan is indulging in the affairs of India, and particularly Jammu and Kashmir. But unfortunately, they did not surrender. Firefight started, and in the firefight, they got neutralized. But we have got enough evidence with us incriminating Pakistan in not only training people, sending terrorist outfits to this side of India to disturb the ongoing process. This incident also is part of the same design, part of the same conspiracy. We would bring the persons accused in this case to book very soon.
Sir, what people behind this attack? And then the PDP worker has also alleged that the J&K police has cut down his security. Even the Miss Mufti has come out with a tweet alleging that
those allegations are baseless. Two PSOs were with him. One PSO is still there. Even bigger amount of PSOs. In case of Wasim Bari, there were 10 PSOs. But an incident took place. So an incident, there is a possibility of, despite the PSOs being there, there is a possibility. That fellow was advised to leave that area because that's a thickly, densely populated area. There's a written record with the police station. He was asked to shift to some safer location. That is not a better location, good location to stay for a protected person. He did not heed to the advice. He was in fact decategorized when he did not go by the security precautions. He regularly violates security precautions. So he was decategorized, security was withdrawn. But again, on the reassessment, security was provided to him. He was an X2 category entitled to one PSO. He was given two PSOs. So all those allegations are baseless.
So who are the people behind this attack?
Motive, as I said already, motive is to disturb the ongoing process of electioneering, which is a very, very big event, and people are very enthusiastically participating in that. And this is also an attempt to disturb the peaceful environment that we have brought in with the cooperation of the people and hard work of the security forces and police. So we will, as I said, definitely bring the accused to law very soon.